Hi, everybody. For those that don't know me, my name is Fred Moafanua. Trying to make it through this without breaking down as best I can. Been part of the family for a couple years now. Met Junior and family through our youngest son. Both our youngest sons played each other in kindergarten, and both of them were like best friends immediately. We hit it off. All I could hear, my youngest one came home now, and he'd be like, "Hey, this kid kind of know this and that. I know, okay. Met his dad, Junior. He was like, finally gets to meet who the hell Leone is and his parents are, because kind of all he does is come home, Leone this, Leone that. And that's pretty much how we hit it off. He actually met my father first, picking up the boys, and then my wife at the playground at school, and ended up saying we'll play date, and that's how we got the kids together. That's how we met the family and everybody. And my first memory of Junior hanging out with him is when I came to just drop off Leone to just hang out with Kainoa. And of course, yeah, his cousins over. They're over there drinking screwdrivers. And he was like, "Come on in, have a drink." I was like, "Come have one." I was okay. And if you know Junior, one is not really just one. So I think we ended up drinking like the whole big bottle of Costco, and then all of a sudden, Kung Fu got into the mix. My wife was going on my phone. I don't know what to do. I was like, "Cancer." She was loud. "Don't worry about it." I was like, "All right, well, I gotta go home." He's like, "You ain't gotta go home. I live 4 blocks away." So, but he was like, "No, you're too drunk. Give me your keys." Took my keys. I was like, "All right." And he just sat me on the couch and put me in bed on his couch. My youngest son and then kind of the kids ended up sleeping in the living room. And I'm like, "Oh my God, all right." So he took my phone and my wife called again. And he picked up and he's like, "Oh, he ain't coming home. He's sleeping right here." I was just like, okay. So I ended up passing out that night. And that was my first night hanging out with Junior. But that was a fun night. My wife was pissed, but hey, you know, it was the first and it wasn't the last. Funny thing with Junior, you know, everybody's talking about how, you know, how handy he is. I mean, he's one of the most handiest guys that I know. I mean, hell, me and my wife were actually in the backyard one time, and we're working on a brand new door, on an office door, and I don't know nothing about how to trim a door or anything like that. I'm not handy at all. But I had a saw, and I said, "All right, we'll make this stick to the measurements," and I started sawing every side of this door this way that Junior walks in to drop off Kaino to hang out, and he looked and he said, "What the hell are you doing?" I was like, "I'm changing the door." And she was like, "You literally trip off." I was like, "Yep." So he fixed it for me as best he could. This door is still there to this day after 2 years, and it's a jacked up looking door. But it still works. And Junior still laughs at me every day he comes in the house and looks at that door. But I'm like, "Better, man." Talk about generosity and everything and great cook. He cooked a lot for me and my family. We've been over at the house plenty of times for meals and everything. It's gonna be rough for me because this last year is where we became the closest after COVID hit. We were literally inseparable. Me and Junior, we hung out almost every day. got with me, where I'm at, and we've been working for months together on the same line. We're carpool buddies. We talk every day. Even on days off, which my wife was annoyed a lot about because I would go spend lunch with him and we'd hang out. We'd have lunch together, have a few drinks, talk stories. And, Junior, he has plenty of stories. And it was never a dull moment. It was never the same conversation twice. We always had something new to talk about. He was just one of the most caring, selfless guys I've ever met. I was with him the last day. I told you, coming out every day. Yeah, whole family got sick during Thanksgiving week. And one day, he came and he made a whole pot of soup for my whole family. He said, "Hey man, this is what I do every time we sit. Make a whole pot of soup, make it for the family. This is what we do, this is how we get rid of all that stuff." And he went out of his way to make this whole pot of soup and brought it to the house. And I couldn't. Made sure we were all good, left, hit me up about an hour later, asked me what I was doing. I was like, finished eating, and just, he was like, "What are you trying to kick out?" I was like, "Of course, man." So we came over to the house, at my house, I got a whole garage gym set up, and we got a heavy bag set up, so, we were doing a little comfy stuff here and there, and just talking, and, he brought his little flask over, and we're just sitting there having a couple drinks, just shooting shit. And just talking about life in general, and he said he wanted to go for a ride. He just wanted to release some stress. And this was, about 3 o'clock in the afternoon on Monday, last Monday. And I was just like, "Yeah, man, if you want to go for a ride, make sure you come back tomorrow, because I'm going to get my sauna fixed." And he goes to help me with my sauna, and they say, "Oh, yeah, we'll hit that up first thing in the morning." Okay. And I was like, "You want to come back to the house again?" I was like, "Okay." So we drove back to the house, had a couple more drinks, just shooting shit, just having a good time. And then I told him, "Just got to go to the store real quick, grab some ice cream for the kids." And he was okay, let's go to the store. And as he was dropping me off back at home, I didn't know he was still gonna go for a ride. We didn't talk about him going for a ride. We were just talking about just how good a friend he was, and I kept thinking of him. I was like, "He went out of your way to bring soup to my entire family and take care of us." And, I was like, "So I gotta do something for you." He's like, "Oh no, man, that's what family does." And when I say goodbye, one thing that I want to regret is that I told him I love him. And that was the last time I said to him. This was at about 6:15 at night. Junior was pronounced dead at 7:10. I'm so sorry, kid. I've played myself every day since that day. least selfish person I've ever known in my life. And I know things had switched. I know he would get in my house every day to check in on my family. So, to the Cauteverio family and everybody that came, that does do not know me. That was my brother. My brother from another.